शिव कुमार बुरली बर्ली BURLI आई हैव अ कॉर्पस ऑफ अबाउट 20 लाख अक्यूमुलेटेड थ्रू SIP इन HDFC इक्विटी एंड HDFC टॉप 100. बोथ आर गिविंग नेगेटिव रिटर्न्स सिंस 3 ईयर्स ड्यू टू देयर एक्सपोजर टू PSU स्टॉक्स. शुड आई स्टे इन्वेस्टेड और स्विच टू कॉर्पोरेट डेट फंड एस आई ओनली 3 ईयर्स टू रिटायर. शिव कुमार, दिस इज़ अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन बिकॉज आई एम अज्यूमिंग योर 3 ईयर्स टू रिटायर, सो यूर 57 ईयर्स ऑफ एज. So first of all, don't get into this theory that at 60 you should be only in debt, you should also be in equity anyway. The question you're asking is, you know why HDFC equity and HDFC top 100 are doing badly. It is because their portfolio has so much of PSU exposure. Now if you see Naren Shankaran, he also has a lot of PSU exposure. Anand Radhakrishnan and Roshi Jain also have a lot of PSU exposure. And if you've seen interviews, Ramdev Agarwal has said, I've lost money because of my exposure to PSU like State Bank of India, right? So everything has happened. Question is, if a Coal India is available at a PE of 5 or 6 and is available at a dividend yield of 10% or 12%, would you buy Coal India? Would you buy NTPC? Would you buy Indian Oil? Would you buy BPCL? I do not know. It's your choice. Now, if these fund managers have chosen that, the question to ask in 2020 is, how will this portfolio look in 2025? Let us assume for a minute that Narendra Modi does some magic and starts working on PSU companies. As of now, there are no indications that he will. I don't think they have any ability to sell BPCL. Right now, everything looks against the PSU. But these fund managers who have had 20-25 years kind of track record have put their money in that. So the question you're asking me is, what is my view on what Naren or Prashant Jain have done? My thing is, with a 25 year track record, you don't argue with them. The question is, I have also invested in HDFC equity and HDFC top 100. I don't like the results, but I also remember that not long ago, 2017 perhaps, I think HDFC equity gave 37% return. Once I see such a return, I'm willing to give a little more time, and I know what has gone wrong. Maybe they bought too much of PSU shares. And knowing that these are fund managers who are very responsible towards client money, maybe they will themselves realign their portfolios and bring it more into what the market wants, or they themselves accept that, okay, PSU was a mistake, so we will come back. So knowing that there are fund managers who will correct their own mistakes, I don't see any reason why we should correct our mistakes. So look at the long-term track record. Yes, they will, I'm convinced that both of them, Naren or Prashant, will relook at their portfolios and see that, okay, this is because of PSU, and they will act accordingly. Once they act, then the markets, the funds will start doing well. So if you are not worried, if you are not worried about the fund manager's competence, and you are just saying, I'm not sure about the PSU call, I think it's your call versus Prashant Jain's call. And I put myself way below Prashant, and I would trust his choice. Maybe he's got it wrong. That's perfectly all right. It is not that in the past he has got it right always. So maybe Naren got it wrong. Maybe Prashant got it wrong. Maybe Anand Radhakrishnan got it wrong. In my own portfolio, I don't have any PSU, so I'm willing to treat these funds as contrarian funds. So other than this money, when you have, maybe you should look at other funds which are international funds or fast growing funds, or you know, any of those kind of funds. So complement this. Don't remove it when it is doing badly just because of the portfolio choice. Because like I told you, I like these portfolios, I do not like the returns. I like the fund managers, I do not like the current working. So, and let me also add that I've been with these funds for 20 years plus. So my position might be different from yours. But should you reallocate to a debt just because you're 3 years away from retirement? Answer is no. You should do it only 3 years before you need the money, not because you're retiring. You don't need money at 60. Maybe you'll get your PF and other stuff, and you may have to invest when you're 60. So no, I will not ask you to remove money just because you're retiring. I will just want you to hold on to it. Thank you.